Good evening. Welcome to East Central High School's Class of 2021 Commencement Ceremony. Today is a very special day for the young men and women in the class of 2021. These graduates have met the necessary requirements for graduation, and today we recognize their great accomplishment. Today marks the end of their 12 school journey, but also the beginning of their next stage of life. Parents and family members, this is a special day for you as well. Like you, we are hopeful these young people have learned the necessary skills to be successful, productive, contributing members of our society. Here at East Central Schools, we are focused on preparing students for the future. And today we formally recognize their preparedness. This school year was one we will never forget. We started the school year with in-person learning, if you remember. Then we switched to hybrid learning. Shortly thereafter, a complete shift to distance learning. And finally, a phased-in return to in-person learning as we know it. We made it. I want to say a heartfelt thank you to our students, our parents, our staff, and our community for your patience, persistence, flexibility, and kindness as we navigated a very difficult year. Especially, though, I want to say thank you to the senior class of 2021. Here we are. We made it. Just a few housekeeping items before we begin. If you need to move up and down the bleachers, please be aware that the bleachers are noisy and can cause distractions to the speakers and attendees. I ask the audience to please silence your cell phones, and for the gentlemen in the audience to please remove your caps. Finally, East Central's commencement is a formal ceremony meant to be respectful and treasured. Loud and ongoing cheering often makes it difficult for families to hear their student's name being called. At the conclusion of the ceremony, we will celebrate with enthusiasm and fun. So please save your wonderful celebrations for later and join the graduates afterwards for pictures. Thank you in advance for your respect of the graduates, families, and our school district. To our graduates, I wish you all the best as you go forward from our school district and explore all the opportunities that will come your way. I am so excited that we could gather today to celebrate with you. Again, to everyone, welcome to commencement for the class of 2021. Congratulations, graduates. And at this time, we begin our ceremony.
I would like to introduce our first senior honors student who will be representing the class of 2021 with one of today's presentations. Please welcome Miss Emma Jansen.
To the class of 2021. It truly does not feel real, the fact that we're sitting here today graduating. Time really is an illusion. By themselves, the school days seem to drag on and on, especially in this last year when you're stuck on Zoom calls for hours on end. But weeks soon turn into months, and before you know it, another entire school year is done, just like that. My many years at East Central have certainly felt like this. At times, it can be hard to remember all the things we accomplish and experience, but we've all spent the last several years together, learning together, joking with one another, and certainly struggling with assignments and tests together. Most importantly, though, we've all grown together. We've grown into these strong, capable individuals who are ready to tackle any obstacle that may come our way. We've grown and made special, lasting connections with one another that will last a lifetime. The relationships we have formed here at East Central are some of the most important ones we'll carry throughout our lives, and it's important that we never forget that. It's equally important to acknowledge that we would not have made it this far without the help of so many others. Our parents, grandparents, teachers, coaches, advisors, counselors, community members, the list could go on and on. They have all put so much of their time and effort into helping us succeed. They have supported us and given us their advice and guidance. They see the potential that we have for shaping the future of our world, even when we couldn't. They see that we can do great things with what we have learned, and for that, we must thank them. Thank them all for believing in us and trusting in us that we can do good in the world. Continue to thank them throughout your future endeavors and for the rest of your lives. And so now, after spending all of these years together, it's time to move up in the world. Some of us will be heading off to college, taking a gap year, taking up an apprenticeship, or joining the military. Whatever it may be, it's inevitable that we'll be experiencing something new. And while that may be daunting, we must remember that we're all going through it together. We have to embrace the uncertainty of the future instead of fear it. If we have learned anything in our time here, especially in this past year alone, it's that we can handle a little change. Besides, isn't it exciting to think that some of the best moments of our lives haven't even happened yet? The saying is maybe a little cliche, but the words still hold true. The best is yet to come. We should be so proud of us all and how far we have all come. For all of us, this is just the beginning. Thank you.
Our next presentation will be presented by Senior Honors Student Ms. Cassidy Thorvig.
Well, guys, we did it. We persevered, and now we are all sitting here together at graduation. Guys, that's a miracle in its own. Our class, the class of 2021, is like no other. We have been through the thick and thin, and we have worked so hard to be here today. Now, I'm not gonna lie, this past year has been tough. We've lost time with friends, events, tournaments, game days, and just days together as a class. Who would have ever thought that we would miss the days of Mr. Stenberg playing the harmonica in class? Over a quarter of our high school experience was spent at home in the comfort of our beds. That is something that only we can understand. And while I may not have enjoyed that time at home, my puppy sure did have some fun. But even through all that ugly, we found a way to make it through. We found a way to push ourselves to keep going and get our work turned in. Kind of like how Emma Jansen found a way to beat all of the boys in the mile run in elementary school. Our class, the class of 2021, has learned how to make the best out of every situation and how to roll with all the punches. No matter how frustrated we may have been, we chose to make the best out of what we were given. This is the same mentality Mr. Erickson had in sixth grade when he was given our grade to teach. He didn't realize how much our class loves pranks. Let's just say the two things he learned from our grade was super glue is sticky and technology is not his friend. Sorry, Mr. Erickson. Towards the end of this year, we were able to find a sense of normalcy again by having a prom and by having a graduation ceremony. In the span of these last couple years, I've learned to take everyday things for granted and to cherish the small things like sitting in class and talking to my friends at lunch. I am so proud of our class and the strength that each one of us has shown to make it to this moment today. It doesn't feel like we should be graduating yet. We are truly Eagle Strong. Right now, it doesn't feel like we should be graduating yet, but I know that it's time to graduate because in our own school, we got kicked off the playground for being too old and scary. So, while we are going to go out on our own separate paths to make our own memories, just never forget the good times that we shared together because when it comes down to it, we are a family. So thank you, parents, teachers, and community members, and thank you, class of 2021. Congrats.
At this time, I would like to acknowledge a student who today will be graduating with not only her high school diploma, but a certificate in both manufacturing production and welding from Lake Superior Community College. It is an honor to congratulate Katherine Lundberg on her accomplishment. Please stand, Katie. A certificate will be presented to Katie at a later date once we finalize everything, so congratulations. At this time, we will now be announcing the scholarships for East Central graduates. These scholarships are made available through regional and local organizations, including the East Central Dollars for Scholars chapters. This year, we will be awarding more than $160,000 in scholarships. This amount does not include the thousands of dollars also awarded in scholarship through the Students Enrolled College. A complete list of scholarships that have been awarded to the graduating class of 2021 is included in the insert in your program. It is great to see the dedication that our community has towards assisting our graduates with college. Our first presenter for tonight is Karen Meyer, who will be presenting the East Central United Educator Teacher Union Scholarship and the Allen Audette Memorial Scholarship.
Well, good evening. Okay, so I'm Karen Meyer, and I'm acting on behalf of Allen's Hope tonight to present the Allen Chatwin Audette Scholarship. Allen's Hope is a nonprofit organization that was created in memory of Allen Audette, who at the age of 16, I'm bad at math, 16 years old, he took his own life. Allen's Hope helps to raise mental health awareness as well as suicide awareness and prevention. Applicants were asked how mental illness has affected them or their family. So on behalf of Allen's Hope, I would like to present a scholarship to Wesley Watrin and to Skylar Esposito. All right, I'm also the East Central United Educators Secretary, so I also get to present the East Central United Educator Scholarship. And this is awarded to the student who is going to be seeking a career in the field of education. So on behalf of the Teachers Union, I would like to present this scholarship to Karamo Touré.
Our next presenter is Karen Carlson. She will be presenting the Sandstone Quarry Lions Scholarship.
On behalf of the Quarry Lions, I want to congratulate you on this very special day. It has been a very unusual year with a lot of hardships and difficulties. But to you as graduates and parents and family members, you are to be congratulated on your hard work. It is an honor to be here tonight to help you celebrate. I wish you much success as you go on to this new adventure after graduation. May your plans bring you much success and happiness and contentment. As I present this scholarship, I call on Chloe Revere to come up and receive the Lions Scholarship.
Presenting the Oak Lake Trinity Health Council Scholarship is Shauna Claussen.
Good evening and congratulations, class of 2021. I am here to award a scholarship from the Oak Lake and Trinity Health Council. Every year we decide to give a scholarship to somebody going into a health-related field. This year our scholarship recipient is Emma Prisky.
Our next scholarship is the Old School Art Center Scholarship presented by Jen Fredrickson.
As she said, my name is Jen and I'm here from the Old School Art Center. Very excited to be presenting this scholarship to Cece Scherheim.
Our next presenter is Marv Nelson. He'll be presenting the Mary Renfors Memorial Scholarship, Mary Thorvig Memorial Scholarship, Dorothy Stockcamp Memorial Scholarship, Helen Pomage Memorial Scholarship, and the Peggy Cahoon Scholarship.
Now it's my turn. As Dollars for Scholars president and on behalf of the Dollars for Scholars board, I'd like to congratulate the seniors on this milestone in your life, and I wish you the best on your life's journey. The following scholarships are being offered in memory of four incredible women who dedicated many years and countless hours to East Central Dollars for Scholars. These women made so many of the scholarships you receive today possible. Without their dedication and commitment to the education of our local students, our Dollars for Scholars scholarship program would have not been able to offer $985,000 in scholarships that we have awarded since 1994, let alone the $136,524 being awarded to students tonight. Our first scholarship is in memory of Mary Renfors, who passed away October 26th of last year. Mary was a retired school staff member, a longtime Dollars for Scholars board member, and worked on fundraising, memorial donations, and spreading the word in the community about the importance of Dollars for Scholars. The Mary Renfors Memorial Scholarship for $1,000 is awarded by East Central Dollars for Scholars in memory of Mary Renfors' commitment as an East Central Dollars for Scholars board member and her service within the school and community. This scholarship is presented to postgrad Jessica Corpy. Our second scholarship is in honor of Mary Thorvig, who passed away January 31st. Mary was a longtime Dollars for Scholars board member and supporter from the earliest years of the program. Mary worked on building our program's endowment funds and was a fierce advocate for the Dollars for Scholars in the community, always hoping that everyone who wanted to go to college would get a scholarship. Mary Thorvig Memorial Scholarship for $1,000 is awarded by East Central Dollars for Scholars in memory of Mary Thorvig to honor her commitment to the chapter, the school, and the community. This scholarship is awarded to postgrad Holly Grunmeier. Our third scholarship is to honor Dorothy Stockamp, who passed away February 6th. Dorothy was a beloved retired teacher and longtime member of the Dollar for Scholars Investment Committee, who helped grow our endowment funds to ensure that East Central students will be receiving much-needed scholarships for decades to come. The Dorothy Stockamp Memorial Scholarship for $1,000 is awarded by East Central Dollars for Scholars in memory of Dorothy Stockamp's commitment to the chapter's investment committee and service to the community. This scholarship is awarded to postgrad Dane Degerstrom Hanley. The next scholarship is in memory of Helen Pomajay of New Prague, Minnesota, who passed away April 3rd. Although she lived more than 100 miles away, every year from 2002 to 2019, she supported Dollars for Scholars by baking hundreds of pies each year for our chapter's annual bake sale. The Helen Pomajay Memorial Scholarship for $1,000 is awarded through an anonymous donation in memory of Helen Pomajay, the mother of retired teacher, play director, and East Central Dollars for Scholars co-founder Kathy Ebnett. Helen gave decades of dedication to East Central Dollars for Scholars and the East Central Theater Department. This scholarship is awarded to postgrad Alex Finch. It is also my privilege to present the Kuhn Scholarship, which is awarded to two individuals attending two-year college. Peggy Cahoon graduated from Bruno School and served the Sansone School District as an elementary teacher and principal. In 2017, she received the Sansone Asgove East Central Hall of Fame Award. The first $1,500 Cahoon Scholarship is awarded to Jenna Hunt. The second $1,500 Cahoon Scholarship is awarded to Mikhail Bishop.
Presenting the Sansone Veterans Memorial Committee Scholarship is Dave Will.
Good evening. It's my honor as a member of the Sansone Veterans Memorial Committee to present a $300 scholarship to a graduating senior of a veteran's family. This year's scholarship goes to C.C. Scherfein.
Our next presenter is Dave DePaulis, awarding the Sansone Lions Scholarships.
Good evening. Congratulations to all of you on reaching this milestone. The Sansone Lions are extremely proud this year to be awarding six scholarships, each in the amount of $1,000. The recipients are as follows: Jayla Schlerett, Thank you, Mrs. Meyer. I'd have never figured that out. C.C. Schirvheim. Chloe Revere. Bruce Wahlberg was a man devoted to family, community, the history of Pine County. He was a steward of the land he worked and a dedicated Lion. We remember Bruce this year with a scholarship awarded to Madeline Anderson. The following award carries with it an honor dear to the Lions' hearts. With it, we remember our son, friend, teammate, classmate, and brother, the Sandstone Lions Club Colton Nelson Memorial Student of the Year, Clay Nelson. And this brings us once again to Carl Steffen. Something that each year reminds me how much it means to me to present these awards, and in particular the Carl Steffen Scholarship. It always takes me at least three drafts to get this right. And I tear up a little bit every time I write it. I suppose if it were to become routine, it would be time for me to step aside. In past years, we've remembered Carl as a charismatic stage performer, his service as a Minnesota State Highway Patrolman, and his fondness for the canine officers he worked and lived with. This year, we remember Carl Steffen, the man. I know I speak for many of us when I say that Carl was one of the most genuine men I've ever known. Whether it was over having coffee at Lions or just out and about, I never had to wonder which Carl I was going to get. There was only one. Supremely confident, fearless, a man gregarious in nature, outgoing, kind, generous, a true friend to all, devoted to family, so proud of his children, his wife, and so how he so enjoyed spending time with them. Although a lot of the time spent with Carl was a bit of a clown show, he took his civic duties and his service to the community very seriously, always doing all he could to make this community better and a place we could be proud to call home. Carl lived life to the last drop. He always seemed to be happiest when those around him were happy. And to this day, he always left you wanting more. What is unique about this year is the student selected for this award embodies all of the same characteristics. Outgoing and kind, generous, a lover of all things fun, an enthusiastic desire to experience fun things yet undiscovered, goal-oriented, driven by perseverance, and a true friend to all, and most certainly genuine in nature. And one thing Carl would be proud of, possibly a bit mischievous. The only lacking characteristic would be Carl's booming laugh that would shake the dust from these rafters. But I have a very close friend, a fellow by the name of Santa Claus, who has indicated to me that on occasion he's seen glimpses, just glimpses of potential in regard to Carl's laugh. Although not on the grand scale that was Carl Steffen, it does nonetheless reflect a true zest for life, as was always the case with Carl. With that, the Sandstone Lions Club presents the Carl Steffen Memorial Scholarship to Emma Jansen. Thank you all. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
All right, we will continue with the rest of our scholarships. When I say your name, please come forward and accept your certificates from Mrs. Youngberg and Mr. Amos. Receiving the Minnesota State University Moorhead Dragon Heart Foundation Scholarship, a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship, Northern Pine Riders Scholarship, and the Methven Funeral Home Scholarship is Madeline Anderson. Receiving the Sebald Motor Sales Scholarship, a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship, and the Northern Pine Riders Scholarship is Mikhail Bishop. Receiving a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Mackenzie Bjorklund. Receiving the Northern Pine Riders Scholarship is Trevor Christensen. Receiving the University of Minnesota Morris Scholar Scholarship, the Sebald Family Scholarship, and a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Elsa Eves. Receiving a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship, Skylar Esposito. Receiving the Forever in Our Hearts Colton Nelson Memorial Scholarship, the O'Brien Transport Inc. Scholarship, and an East Central Energy Scholarship is Easton Hartle. Receiving the Eugene Laurie Memorial Scholarship is Jenna Hutt. Receiving the St. Olaf College Presidential Scholarship, the National Honor Society Scholarship, Hosier Foundation Scholarship, the Sebald Family Scholarship, and a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Emma Jansen. Receiving the East Central Sports Booster Scholarship, the Chris Thorvig Memorial Scholarship, and a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Desmond Letexier. Receiving a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Gabe Colon. Receiving the Askove Commercial Club Scholarship and a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Brody Lindstrom. Receiving the Sandstone Healthcare Center Scholarship and a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Elena Matrius. Receiving the Sandstone Chamber of Commerce Scholarship and a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Clayton Nelson. Receiving the Falcons Scholars Endowed Scholarship, the Falcons Flying Higher Scholarship, the Falcons Soar Scholarship, the Gordon Senior and Irene Britton Scholarship, and a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Emma Prisky. Receiving the St. Olaf College Faculty Scholarship, Northview Bank Scholarship, a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship, and a Northern Pine Rider Scholarship is Chloe Revere. Receiving the Essentia Health Sandstone Scholarship and a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Jayla Schlerit. Receiving the University of Minnesota Twin Cities Promise Plus Scholarship, the Colton Nelson Memorial Scholarship, and a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Taya Schlerit. Receiving the Masonic Lodge 233 Ancient Free and Accepted Nations Scholarship, a UW Gap Scholarship, the East Central Energy Scholarship, a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship, and the Tozier Foundation Scholarship is Cecilia Scherfheim. Receiving a National Honor Society Scholarship, the Order of the Eastern Star 158 Mora Chapter Scholarship, the Minnesota Grocers Association Scholarship, a St. Thomas Academic Achievement Scholarship, the Roland Tice Memorial Scholarship, an East Central Sports Booster Scholarship, a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship, and a Northern Pine Rider Scholarship is Cassidy Thorvig. Receiving an East Central Energy Scholarship, the Federated Co-op Scholarship, and a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Tyler Thorvig. Receiving a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Karamo Touré. Receiving a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship is Wesley Watron. Additional East Central postgraduates receiving a Dollars for Scholars Scholarship include Dane Dagerstrom-Hanley, Allison Downs, Annika Eves, Jillian Fote, Aaron Gamps, Elizabeth Grosskreutz, Holly Grunmeyer, Jay Hansen, Jillian Hansen, Rebecca Jurgensen, Ashlyn Clocky, Matt Clocky, Jessica Corpy, Melody Kozvab, Haley Lowe, Hope Loeb, Lori Bowen, Madison Nelson will also receive an anonymous donor scholarship. Mark Nelson, Barrett Peterson, Jameson Seibert will also receive a Dr. Paul and Bridget Dewey scholarship. Sophia Seibert will also receive the Alice Erickson Memorial Scholarship. Deanna Stadine, Sadie Sura, Willow Thomas, Elaine Wittenberg, who will also receive the Doug Carlson Memorial Scholarship. Congratulations to you all.
School board, staff, administration, and parents. The students sitting among us have successfully met the requirements for graduation set forth from the high school and the Minnesota State of Minnesota and the East Central Board of Education. Along with that go the rights and responsibilities of being positive and contributing citizens of our society. Congratulations. It is now time to present diplomas to the East Central's graduating class of 2021. Row one, Abigail Ann Anderson. Avery A. Anderson. Madeline R. Anderson. Stephen Matthew Anderson. Hunter T. Barber. Row two. Mikhail Curtis Bishop. Mackenzie Lynn Bjorklund. Shaylee Mercedes Bowen. Noah Dylan Michael Bowerman. Brian Bloom. Row three. Carter James Briggle. Luke David Carlson. Brianna Jean Childers. Trevor J. Christensen.
Alexander Matthew Dagerstrom. Row 4. Elsa Ann Eves. Skylar Jordan Esposito. Adam J. Fernango. Raven T. Frederick. Morgan Ann Gelly. Row 5. Aiden Joseph Groff Frazier. McCoy Allen Grover. Ava May Gutnick. Shelby Lynn Hackbarth. Easton Michael Hartle. Row 6. Jenna Elaine Hutt. Emma C. Jansen. Sky Jensen. Brandon John Kanowski. Ariana Michelle Karenin. Row 7. Sage Marie Kanopic. Gabriel G. Colon. Desmond T. Letexier. Brody Kenneth Lindstrom. Catherine Grace Lundberg. Row 8. Serino Martinez. Elena Ray Lee Matrius. Emily L. Mott Smith. Clayton Wallin Nelson. Mackenzie Marie Olson. Row 9. Autumn Angelina Perry. Emma Lauren Prisky. Chloe May Revere. Jayla Maylin Marie Chalerit. Taya Star Shalerit. Cecilia Therese Shervheim. Row 10. Tucker James Sill. Lindsay Nicole Staples. Cassidy Paige Thorvig. Tyler Lewis Thorvig. Caramo Dennis Touré. Wesley Peter Watrin. Graduates, please stand. The East Central faculty and staff wish you well on life's journey. We hope that your education at East Central will help you find peace, happiness, and success. Ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present to you the East Central graduating class of 2021. Guests, please remain seated until all graduates and honor guards have left the gymnasium. There will be a receiving line on the sidewalk outside of the activities door.
Don't blink, just like that. that high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink, you just might miss your babies growing like mine did. Turning into moms and dads, next thing you know, you better have a 50 years is there in bed. And you're praying God takes you instead. Trust me, friend, 100 years goes faster than you think. So don't blink. I was glued to my TV when it looked like you looked at me and said, best start putting first things first. Cause when your hourglass runs out of sand, you can't rip it over and start again. Take every breath God gives you for what it's worth. Don't blink, just like that, you're 6 years old. Take a nap and wake up and you're 25. Then your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink, you just might miss your babies growing like mine did. Turning into moms and dads, next thing you know, you better have a 50 years is there and there. And you're praying God takes you instead. Trust me, friend, 100 years goes faster than you think. So don't blink. So I've been trying to slow it down, I've been trying to take it in, and this here today, gone tomorrow world we're living in. Don't blink, just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap and wake up and you're 25 and your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink, you just might